With Giles.
Yeah, what's up?
The drummer was here. He said he can't make it. What are you gonna do?
Me, I'm just afraid to be here all alone.
change I spent on you. Where have the time? Playing of our national anthem in prayer. As we begin, we would like to acknowledge that we are on sacred territory and thank the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation for being stewards of this land. Good morning, everyone. Please remain standing for today's reflection and prayer, and let's begin with the sign of our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today's psalm, the first of the book of Psalms, is about finding happiness through hope in our Lord. The psalmist articulates that happiness does not come to those who take the path of sinners or follow the path of the wicked, but rather to those who delight in the law of the Lord. As we continue to shape our Lenten goals of prayer, fasting, and giving, it's up to us then to figure out what wickedness we are surrounded by that is hindering us from true happiness in God. Perhaps it's our constant fascination with celebrity status, money, or power. Perhaps we are consumed by desires for unhealthy habits that provide instant gratification but no long-term joy. Perhaps our culture of materialism and consumerism has clouded our perspective of what holds true value. Perhaps we have engaged in gossip, bullying, or hurtful speech that has isolated or turned others away from us. You see, the Old Testament stories of wickedness and sin sometimes sound very far removed. But when we examine our own lives, our own minds, and our own hearts, we can see that the temptations that draw us away from true happiness in our Lord are ever present. The context and circumstances may have changed, but the presence of sin remains. And so we pray. Lord, help us to acknowledge our own sinfulness by taking a hard look at how our desires and actions shape our relationships with others, with creation, with our own self-worth, and most importantly, with you. Guide us to a deep joy by placing our trust in you and not in our worldly possessions. Let us find freedom in your word by living fully with love, respect, and joy. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Our Lady of Mount Carmel, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Be blessed, Mount Carmel. Here's Amelia with today's announcements.
Good morning, Our Lady of Mount Carmel. My name is Amelia, and here are your morning announcements. Do you need any school supplies? Students who need a binder, pencil case, or other school supplies can see Mrs. Dorego in room 118 between 8:30 and 11 a.m. Mrs. Dorego can be found in the guidance office after 11 a.m. Be sure to join the SST Google Classroom to connect with Mrs. Dorego for extra help and support. The class code is 3VZA5F5. Please complete the student success profile. CIA meets today at 2:30 p.m. New members are always welcome. The Google Classroom code is GFONR37. Support Services Google Classroom. Please visit the Support Services Google Classroom to access mental health and well-being resources. The Google Classroom code is 37H3DCD. You can have grade 11 and 12 SHSM students. Grade 11 and 12 SHSM students are reminded of to attend the workshop today at 2:30 p.m. A Meet link will be posted in the Google Classroom. And now for a video from our Black Futures Lab.
The next topic of our Celebrating Black History Month series is the great era of the Montreal jazz scene. From the 1920s to 1950s, jazz ruled Montreal. While birthed in New Orleans, jazz greats found a haven of culture in Montreal versus the United States during the American Prohibition. Despite the many negative attributes given to jazz and jazz lovers, the genre continued to rise and became more than just music. Join us today as we learn about the influence of the Montreal jazz scene and how its legacy continues to impact the Black community in Montreal. Jazz ruled Montreal from the 1920s to the 1950s. Birthed in New Orleans, Louisiana, the rhythms and melodies of jazz migrated to Montreal and flourished during the height of the Great Depression. Montreal would produce iconic jazz figures such as Oscar Peterson, Myron Sutton, Maynard Ferguson, and Oliver Jones. Black Americans were responsible for the creation of jazz. This combination of blues, ragtime, spirituals, and band music traveled across the border during the 1920s and would attract many of the greatest jazz musicians to Montreal during the 1930s. While most North American nightclubs were segregated, many Black jazz musicians found integration in Montreal. Despite its roots in the Black community, jazz was discovered by the rest of the United States and appropriated for white audiences. Jazz was considered evil and rebellious. This is because jazz was originally known to be included in Montreal nights of sinful pleasure. The American Prohibition, lasting from 1920 to 1933, greatly fueled the rise of jazz in Montreal. Being one of the few places where alcohol was legal, Montreal attracted entertainers, gamblers, racketeers, and American jazz musicians. This era of Montreal is considered to be its Sin City era. Myron Sutton, an alto saxophone player, was a part of Canada's first organized Black jazz band called the Canadian Ambassadors. They played at Connie's Inn on St. Catherine Street in 1933 wearing tailor-made suits. As jazz was rising during the 1930s, so were the dreams of a local, musically skilled young boy named Oscar Peterson. Oscar performed at smaller venues such as community halls and in churches with his family band. Oscar Peterson would go on to have his own radio show in Montreal and dominate the jazz scene throughout the next decade, becoming one of Canada's most famous musicians. The rise of jazz in Montreal played a significant role in the development of Montreal's Black community. The Canadian Black population had begun to grow in 1897 when Canadian railways began hiring, but underpaying, Black porters. Although they would have to live and work in the city, Black porters were not allowed to bring along their wives or children. Therefore, the majority of Montreal's Black population at the time were single Black men with disposable income. This allowed for the creation of a market for Black entertainment venues. From 1897 to the 1920s, there were three Black clubs. The first club, called the Nemdurlach Club, which is colored men backwards, was strongly disliked by the Black community for its endorsement of gambling, prostitution, and drinking. When jazz began its ascension to popularity, it was also disliked by older generations. In an article titled, "Does Jazz Put the Sin in Syncopation?" Anne Shaw Faulkner claims that jazz is damaging to the brain and writes, "Never in the history of our land have there been such moral conditions among our young people. The blame is laid on jazz music and its evil influence." As the media began associating the negatives of jazz with the Black community and referring to swing dancing as Negro dancing, much of the Black community also publicly expressed their detest for the music in an effort to escape white-held stereotypes. Many of Montreal's Black communities agreed that jazz was an inferior music genre. In many Black households, jazz was discouraged and Black children were trained in classical instruments. However, jazz would not die but would continue to be a prominent influence within the Black community. Today, jazz is still celebrated in Montreal. Each year, Montreal holds the Festival International de Jazz de Montréal. Established in 1980, this festival is one of the premier jazz events in the world and attracts up to 400,000 people. The legacy of jazz and the influence of the Black community lives on in Montreal.
And those are all of your announcements, Our Lady Mount Carmel. Have a wonderful day.